Welcome to the first annual Battle of the Blue Bonnet Books Elementary Competition. I'm Kim Baker, I'm the author of Pickle. Let's start with the rules. Number one, the team with the most points at end will win the battle. Number two, each table will be given a question. Your team will have to discuss the question and answer within 15 seconds. Number three, in the event of a tie, there will be a tie-breaking question. Number four, each question is worth 10 points. Number five, disruptive or unsportsmanlike behavior gets a warning, minus 10 points after the warning. Number six, three librarians for judges, one librarian for timer, one scorekeeper. Number seven, rules do not change unless conferred with Mrs. Nora Galvan. Number eight, one team captain per campus for answering. And number nine, only judges can make clarifications. And now we'll begin. You guys ready? All right. Good luck. The first question is about Pickle by Kim Baker. Question one, Hector and Ben stopped at the bodega and ate and drank what? Anaya, this question is for Anaya. I should have said that. Time's up.
Orange juice.
Judges? Can you elaborate, please?
Orange juice.
Judges? The answer was pan dulce and orange juice. Arnold, the next question is for you, also about Pickle by Kim Baker. Question number two, the last summer before school started, someone wrote with permanent marker on the back door building. What did it say?
On the door, it said, Principal Duty Head lives here.
That is correct. Well done. Cantu, the next question is for you about Pickle by Kim Baker. What would Hector have to eat if he did not start telling the truth? This was compared to kryptonite. Yes, correct. Clover, question four. What grade level of students do a lot of the same tricks again and again? What grade level of students do a lot of the same tricks again and again in Pickle?
Sixth grade.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. It's high school. You guys ready? Question number five about Pickle. Ben knew he needed two things to be successful at the pranks. What were they?
Supplies and courage.
Sorry, that's incorrect. The answer is a plan and help. All right, Garza. Question six about Pickle. Hector could not keep a secret, according to Ben, even with a mouthful of what?
We don't know.
Okay, the answer is pudding. Leave us. Question seven about Pickle. Frank wore what kind of sunglasses, like a cop or a biker?
Shotgun.
top.
Incorrect. It's mirrored sunglasses. McKeever, question 8 about pickle. At Ben's family restaurant, they make enchiladas with something on top. And what kind of chili?
We don't know.
I don't know. It's green chili and an egg on top. My favorite kind of enchiladas. Palmer, question 9 about pickle. When Principal Lebonski went to eat at Lupe's, her friend ordered fajitas while she ordered this.
She ordered the tacos.
Correct. Anaya, question 10 about pickle. Mrs. Ruiz lent Ben a book about making pickles. What was the title of the book?
The Joy of Pickling.
Correct. Arnold, question 11 about pickle. How much money did the League of Pickle Makers receive to start their club?
They received $50.
Correct. Cantu, question 12 about pickle. Oliver remembered he'd seen some vinegar in one of the cupboards in the science lab when they made what?
The volcanoes?
Correct. Clover, question 13 about pickle. Hector wanted to know what kind of club Ben was organizing, and at first his instinct was to lie, but he remembered he had to cover the pickle club, but what was he going to say?
If he could be in the club?
I'm sorry?
If he could be in the club.
Can I repeat the question? I think it got confusing. Hector wanted to know what kind of club Ben was organizing, and at first his instinct was to lie. But then Ben remembered that he had to cover for the pickle club. So what did he say? But what was he going to say?
We don't know.
All right. A crossword puzzle club. Question 14 about pickle. Hector wanted to eat at Pete's Pizza, but he was afraid that Pete would mention the balls or that Principal Lebonski would trace the balls back to Pete, so they went to eat where?
Loops.
Incorrect. The answer is Pizza Palace. Garza, question 15 about pickle. The plates used at Sienna's party were from the Chinese New Year. What did they say?
The year of the dragon?
Incorrect. It was the year of the pig. These are tricky. Question 16. The confetti used on the tables for Sienna's party said what? Or leave us.
Happy birthday, Sienna.
Incorrect. The confetti said class of 2011. Question number 17 about pickle for McKeever. Ben wanted to name the club Secret Agency of Pranksters, but Prank said they would be known as what?
PGA.
Incorrect. If it was the Secret Agency of Pranksters, they'd be known as SAP, SAP. Palmer, question 18 about pickles. What did the PTA stand for?
Pizza Prank and Tricks Association.
Correct. Anaya, question 19 about pickle. The PTA did not have enough money for a fog machine, but they did have enough money for what?
Dry ice.
Correct. Arnold, question 20. What was the name of the store the PTA purchased the dry ice from for the prank?
We don't know.
It was Farley's Grocery. Kantu, question 21 about pickle. How much money did they spend on the dry ice for the prank?
$21?
Correct. Question 22 for Clover. What did Sienna say her mother's job was?
An agent?
Can you elaborate, please? What kind of agent?
A secret agent?
Incorrect. It was a real estate agent. Question 23. On what day of the week does Sienna's dad call?
Say one more time.
Saturdays.
Correct. Question 24 for Garza. What is the code name for Frank when using email?
Trippin?
I'm sorry?
What? Trimmin? Trimmin.
Nope, Frank is Agent Fix-It. Livas, what is the code name for Oliver when using email?
Agent 008.
Correct. McKeever, what code name did Sienna use when using email?
Agent Snow.
Correct. Palmer, question 27. What gooey tradition did Fountain Point Middle School have every first Friday of the month?
To serve macaroni for lunch.
Correct. Anaya, question 28. Ben made a lot of boiled eggs in a big pot they used to make what food for the restaurant?
Pickle eggs.
Incorrect. The restaurant they used it for manure. Arnold, question 29. By accident, Ben ate what insect and was completely grossed out?
He accidentally ate a cockroach.
Yes, correct. Terrible. Kantu, Mrs. Ruiz reserved a cupboard for the Pickle Club and made a sign using permanent marker on green construction paper that said what?
League of Pickle Makers use only?
Correct. Clover, what was Ben's Halloween costume?
What was it? Like an army? An army guy?
An army guy? Incorrect. He was a matador. Question 32. Hector had a record of tattletaling and one time told on Bean for something she had done. What was it?
Putting gum under the desk.
Correct. Garza, question 33. Ben told the PTA they could make escabeche. What is escabeche?
Salsa with chips and...
Some chips. But what is it made out of?
Tomatoes and onions.
I'm sorry?
Tomatoes and onions.
Judges, incorrect. It's spicy carrots, onions, pickled vegetables, jalapenos. Libas, question 34. What did Mrs. Ruiz lend the pickle club to display their pickled items?
The punch bowl.
Correct. Kiever, what did the escabeche taste like?
We don't know.
Sour chili garlic. Palmer, question 36. What did Sienna do for her prank?
She released a box of about 1,000 crickets into the gym.
Correct. The next set of questions will be based on the book The Day the Crayons Quit by Drew DeWalt. Anaya, first question. What crayon is used for big animals?
Gray crayon.
Correct. Arnold, which question thinks he works the hardest? Which crayon? Did I say question? Crayon.
Blue crayon?
Incorrect. The red crayon. Cantu, how does Duncan respond to the letters?
He colors a picture with all of the crayons.
Judges? Can you elaborate?
He colors a picture with all the crayons.
Can you elaborate? Tell me more about it. Please.
He gets an A plus for creativity.
Incorrect. The answer is he drew a picture that took into account the suggestions in the letter. He used the colors differently, used the colors that he did not use before, etc. Clover. Which crayon is not in the rainbow?
White.
Correct. Which crayon is the neatest?
Purple.
Correct. Garza, why are yellow and orange no longer speaking?
They're fighting over the color of the sun. Who's the right color of the sun?
Correct. Which crayon does Duncan think is a girl's color, Libas?
Pink.
Correct. McKeever, what was the bad news that Blue included in his letter?
That he was so short.
Can you elaborate? Can you tell me more?
He used them every time.
No, I'm sorry, it's incorrect. It was short and stubby and couldn't see over the railing. Palmer, which crayon even works on holidays?
Red crayon.
Yes. Anaya, what is the black crayon upset about?
He is only used by drawing outlines.
Correct. Arnold, Why is the peach crayon naked?
Because Duncan peeled off his wrapper.
Correct. What does beige crayon color?
Wheat and turkey dinners if he's lucky.
Correct. What color did Duncan use in his final drawing that hadn't been used before? Time's up.
Peach?
Incorrect, it's pink. What is Duncan's favorite crayon?
Blue crayon.
Correct. Garza, what did Duncan find when he went to take out his crayons?
Letters in his backpack.
I'm sorry?
Letters in his backpack.
Correct. Libas, what did pink crayon ask Duncan to do?
To use some more.
Incorrect. He asked to thank his sister for using the pink crayon in her coloring book. Which crayon is happy with the things that Duncan colors?
Green.
Correct. There was a duplicate question, but what two crayons are no longer talking to each other?
Yellow and orange.
Correct. And that's it for the day the crayons quit. Well done. This next set of questions will be about Rump by Liesl Shurtleff. Anaya, question number 24. Name three characters from Rump.
Red, King Barf, and Frederick.
Correct. Arnold, question number 22. What did the miller do for Rump when he was caught by the King of the Gold Thread? Question number 22. Yes. What did the miller do for Rump when he was caught by the king with the gold thread?
The miller said it wasn't Rump's gold, it was his gold.
Correct. Question 19 for Kanto. What advice did Red give Rump after seeing Gran very ill with a fever and listening to Red's mother say she's old and no one lasts forever? Rump had an idea to trade his gold skeins for food. What advice did Red give to Rump after seeing Gran very ill with a fever and listening to Red's mother say she's old and no one lasts forever? Rump had an idea to trade his gold skeins for food, and Red gave him advice.
That magic comes with consequences.
Okay. Question number 16. In the beginning of the story, chapter 1, who are the two boys that bullied Rump and how do they relate to the miller?
Frederick and Bruno.
And how do they relate to the miller?
They were the miller was their dad.
Correct. Question 13 for Clover. What does Red's grandmother give Rump when he goes to her for advice?
Can you repeat it?
Yes. What does Red's grandmother give Rump when he goes to her for advice? Do you have an answer?
Tells him to find a steel skin?
Incorrect. Question number 10. What happens when Rump tries to make his first deal with the miller?
He has to give the grains but and some gold, but what's it? Why am I gonna get it wrong? But he only gets half of it.
Incorrect. His tongue gets stuck in his mouth and he is unable to bargain. Garza, question number 7. What advice does Red's granny give Rump in order to find his name?
To find a steel skin?
I'm sorry?
To find a steel skin.
Judges, incorrect. The answer is to follow your destiny to find your name. You may get in trouble at first, but you will find it. Question number 4. Pixies are always obsessed with what?
Gold.
Correct. McKeever, question number 1. Why didn't Rump receive his full name when he was born?
Because his mother died before she could finish saying it.
Correct. Palmer, question number 27. Why did Rump have to go back for Opal's baby?
So he can make the trade fair.
He could make the trade?
The bargain.
You made a trade for, so he could make a trade for a bargain?
Yes.
Judges, would you like elaboration? Could you please elaborate?
So he could actually.
Can you hold the mic up, Miha?
So he could actually do the promise.
More.
So he could complete the promise he made with the miller.
Incorrect. The answer is Opal promised her child in return for Rump changing the straw into gold. Anaya, question number 25. How old is Rump?
Twelve.
Correct. Arnold, question number 20. What did winter really mean for the people of the mountain?
That there would be less food?
Correct. That the passage would be soon be closed for trading gold for food. Kantu, question number 17. The gnomes had jobs. What were they?
To send messages?
Correct. Clover, question number 14. How does Rump get inside the castle gates?
He sneaks in there.
Can you elaborate?
He gets a rope and starts climbing in the window.
Incorrect. He hides in a cart of hay being delivered. Audience, question number 11. Why does King Bartholomew come to the mountain?
To collect gold.
Can you elaborate, Ellen?
To collect gold from the village, from the mines.
Correct. The judges will accept it. Garza, question number 8. How does Kessler the Peddler's magic trick go wrong? Yes. How does Kessler the Peddler's magic trick go wrong?
The rats start chasing him.
Can you say it a little louder?
The rats, they chase him.
Can you repeat your answer now?
The rats, they were still with him. Were with him.
You said they were chasing him?
Yeah.
The first time. Sure. The judges will confer, contestants. Yes, they will accept your answer, Garza.
Can you answer?
Can I say the answer? Yes. He turned Fluff into a mouse, and more mice started coming to him. Leave us. Question number 5. What does Rump like to make up when he feels down? Hint, something you say. Time's up.
Rhyme.
Correct. McKeever, question number 2. What present did Frederick and Bruno give Rump on his birthday?
Poop.
Did you just say that into a microphone? Yes. The correct answer is poop. Question number 26 for Palmer. Name one of his aunts.
Ida.
Correct. The other two aunts are Belfilda and Hadel. Do we do one more time around? We're done? And that is all for Rump by Liesl Shurtleff. Well done, contestants. So official with the envelopes. Like the Oscars. Thank you. Our next set of questions will be regarding Lester's Dreadful Sweaters by K.G. Campbell. Anaya, question number 23. What was wrong with the sweaters?
They were ugly and they had holes where they weren't supposed to be.
Can you repeat your answer, please?
They were ugly and they had holes where they weren't supposed to be.
They were ugly and they had holes where they weren't supposed to be. Correct. Arnold, question number 20. When the clowns asked Clara if she would miss her family, what did she say?
She said, I don't know if we're even related.
Correct. Question number 15. What sound would Lester hear when Cousin Clara knitted?
Clickety clack.
Judges? Correct. Question number 8. What did Lester find ghastly?
Can you repeat it?
Yes. Question number 8. What did Lester find ghastly?
The mountain of sweaters?
Can you please clarify your answer?
What is it? What does that mean?
Make it more specific. Do you have a more specific answer?
Or explain in more detail. Tell us more.
Like, he got mad that there was a bunch more sweaters?
I'll repeat the question. What did Lester find ghastly?
His aunt made a mountain of sweaters. It's gonna be wrong.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The answer was just the sweater. Darlene's? The pink sweater. It was an irksome pink and dotted with upside down pockets. It was ghastly. Question number 5. What are Lester's feelings about the yellow and purple pom-pom sweater Cousin Clara made for him?
It was dreadful.
Correct. Question number 3. When Clara arrives, what two words are used to describe her?
Little and frilly.
Correct. Libas. Question number 24. What did the clowns like about Lester's outfit?
It was cute.
Can you elaborate?
They liked it, the clowns?
Incorrect. The answer was the feathers and the feet. Question number 21 for McKeever. What do Lester's parents force him to do?
Wear the sweaters to school.
Correct. Wear the sweaters and say thank you. Question number 16 for Palmer. Who offered Cousin Clara a job?
The clowns.
Correct. Anaya, question number 13. After arriving at the birthday party, Lester was confused for a...
A clown.
Correct. Arnold, question number 6. Mr. Twist compliments Lester every day on his...
He compliments him on his neatly knotted tie. And neatly combed hair.
Correct. His hair. Question number two. Lester had a list going. What was the name of the list which he included crocodiles?
Suspicious things starting with C.
Correct. Clover, question number 22. Who is the bully in the story? Time's up.
Eeny, measles,
correct. Donnie's question number 19. What caused Lester's parents to say some loud and angry stuff?
When he cut up all the sweaters.
Correct. Question 14. The clowns went nuts on seeing Cousin Clara's freshly knitted collections. What were their reactions toward the sweaters?
They were asking, where'd you get the stylish suit and all fresh and everything. They wanted to know or who made them for you and everything.
Correct. Question number 7. What did Lester consider a mysterious accident? Time's up, I'm sorry.
The messed up sweater?
Can you please elaborate? Be more specific.
In the lawnmower?
I'm sorry?
In the lawnmower?
I'm sorry, no, that's incorrect. They found a sweater in the laundry, all stringy and shrunken. Keeper, question number 4. What does Cousin Clara enjoy doing?
Knitting.
Correct. And Palmer, last question. Question number 1. What consumed Cousin Clara's cottage?
A crocodile.
Correct. And that concludes our questions about Lester's Dreadful Sweaters by K.G. Campbell. Well done, contestants. All right, Anaya. And now for clarification on another question, we are going to ask you a bonus round question regarding Lester's Dreadful Sweaters by K.G. Campbell. Question number 10. Lester's sweater was discovered in an inexplicable tragedy in the yard, shredded by a what?
Lawnmower.
Correct. Okay, we have 3 schools that have tied, Palmer, Cantu, and Anaya. I will ask each of you a question. Starting with Palmer. Question number 11 about Lester's Dreadful Sweaters. Who considers themselves as a curiously speedy knitter?
Cousin Clara.
Correct. And then Anaya. Question number 9 about Lester's Dreadful Sweaters. Who compliments Lester on how nicely he knots his tie?
The teacher.
Can you elaborate, please? Be more specific. We need his name or her name. The specific name, please. Do you have an answer?
No.
I'm sorry, it's Mr. Twist was the name we are looking for. And now, Cantu, your tiebreaker question. Also from Lester's Dreadful Sweaters by K.G. Campbell. Question number 12. Lester was invited to whose party?
Enid Measles?
Correct. So now we have a tie between Cantu and Palmer. Our first tiebreaker question will go to Cantu, and it's about Rump by Liesl Shurtleff. Question number 12. What important information does the Witch of the Forest give Rump about what happens each time he spins gold?
He gets tied in a rump? Rumple, sorry.
Can you clarify your answer, please?
He got stung. Every time he would spin the gold, he would get stronger and stronger into a rumple.
The judges are conferring. I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The answer is you cannot bargain for a fair trade. You must accept whatever is offered you. And Palmer, your tiebreaker question, also about Rump by Liesl Shurtleff. Question number 6, why was Gran so frail and withered?
Because she was on the brink of death.
Can you repeat the answer?
Because she was on the brink of death.
Because she was on the brink of death. Can you elaborate? Do you want me to say that? What caused her to be on the brink of death?
An illness.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. She has been giving her food to Rump because he was a growing boy. This makes it more tense, right? The tension.
Even the judges are flustered.
All right, we've done the tiebreaker round, we've done the bonus round, this must be the lightning round. The next two questions will be about Pickle by Kim Baker. Cantu, we'll start with you. Question number 38, what did the soccer players do when they found out all extracurricular activities were canceled?
They cried.
Judges? Do you want me to ask a follow-up question?
Sorry?
Do you want me to ask a follow-up question?
Yes.
Where did they cry?
In the gym.
In the gym.
The judges will accept your answer. And now, Palmer. For your final question, maybe. Question number 39. What was the plan of the PTA to spread the word about the protest?
To rally at the gym during the presentation.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The answer was the 6 of them would tell 6 people, and then those people would tell 6 more, and so on. I think we have a winner. Congratulations to all the contestants. You guys were so amazing, and I was so impressed with how well read you are. And Cantu, you have won with 110 points. Congratulations.